السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته طلابي الأعزاء Dear students grade 8 This is Abdullah Mehjez, English teacher It's nice to meet you here in our first electronic session using technology to defend corona pandemic As you know, we face a very dangerous virus and we need to overcome this virus using any type of technology So Today's lesson is about different people, different clothes. It's important for you to know that different clothes may refer to different people. احنا لازم نعرف بشكل مهم جدا انه تغير وتنوع الملابس give us signs to different people. لما نكون عندي الملابس تتغير فتغير الملابس بيعطيني إشارات لاختلاف الناس. If I ask anybody of you to number some of the clothes, you would mention shirt, t-shirt, jacket, جلبية, ساري, bridal, mask, petal dress. But how would different clothes refer to different people? Yes, I need some answers. I assume that some of you would say that clothes tell us about gender. Yes. ألا تخبرنا الملابس أن هذا رجل وهذه امرأة هذا ولد وهذه بنت Yes, I believe so because in every nation, every country, in every culture girls have different clothes rather than boys الأولاد بيلبسوا ملابس مختلفة عن البنات Am I right? What else can clothes tell us? I believe it can tell us about social status انت ما بتعتقدش انه الملابس ممكن تقول لنا انه هذا غني وهذا فقير yes of course clothes can tell us that this man is rich and this man is poor what else can clothes tell us it can tell about age هل يعقل الاستاذ اللي عمره 40 ولا 30 سنه يلبس نفس لباس الشاب No, of course. So clothes tell us about age. It tells us more. Clothes tell us more about religion. Yes. When we see a sheikh, he has some clothes that are different from others. Priest يعني القسيس بيلبس ملابس مختلفة عن الشيخ. Okay, what else can clothes tell us? Yes, it can tell us about culture. Yes, so for example, in China, a bride wear what? إيش بتلبس العروس في الصين؟ A black dress. فستان أسود. But here in Palestine or in Egypt or Jordan, she wears, yes, white dress. So that tells us what? Different cultures. الملابس بتدللي على اختلاف الثقافات. مثلا في الصين العروس ايش بتلبس؟ فستان اسود. لكن في فلسطين والدول العربية ايش بتلبس؟ الفستان الابيض. What else can clothes tell us? It can tell about ceremony. المناسبات. هل احنا في العيد بنلبس نفس اللباس اللي بنلبسه في الايام العادية؟ في زواج اخوك او اختك هل بتلبس نفس الملابس اللي في الايام العادية؟ No. Clothes may tell us about jobs. Yes. You can say that this is a doctor or this is a nurse. He is a policeman. He is a firefighter. He is a mechanic. Using what? Using your eyes to tell you that he wear a specific type of a clothes. Yes, more clothes can tell us about nationality. الجنسية. اليوم أنا إذا شفت واحد لابس جلابية وغطرة وعقال بقول هو خليجي. إذا شفت بنت لابس الساري بقول هندية. وأستطيع أن أميز. I can distinguish the Chinese people by their clothes. Okay. Now let's go to the second section, which talks about the new vocabs. We have a new vocabs. It is important for you to learn. مفردات مهمة جدا. مهمة جدا أن نتعلمها. You can find this vocabs on page 4. افتح كتابك صفحة 4 إذا متوفر الكتاب. واسمع. Look and listen. Look and listen.
Assistant. Centimeter. Crazy about. Grade. Just. Size. Smart.
Thank you. Now, I repeat the words. Assistant. And I need you to know that the word assistant has two parts. كلمة assistant مكونة من شقين. واحد منهم assist, and it is the verb يساعد. Assistant بإضافة ant تصبح مساعد. Centimeter, crazy about, a grade, exactly or just, size and smart. Now let us move to this exercise. There is a dialogue between Ahmed and his mom. Ahmed needs to buy a new clothes and he tells his mom about that. We have some words عند بعض الكلمات. كلمة shop اللي هي متجر is connected to some other words. مرتبطة بكلمات أخرى to combine what? عشان تشكل إيش? Compound word. بتشكل لي كلمة مركبة. So we have sports shop, coffee shop, shoe shop, clothes shop. I need you to write this exercise on your notebook. اكتب هذا التمرين على دفترك and give yourself 2 or 3 minutes before continuing this video. ما تكملش هذا الفيديو. اكتب الآن. حاول تحل هذا التمرين. أعطي نفسك دقيقتين. أوقف الفيديو. أعطي نفسك دقيقتين. وبعد ذلك حل التمرين وتابع الفيديو لتصحح أخطائك. Okay? Now let me read. أحمد. Mom, I have to play a match today. I need to go to. Mom, not now, Ahmed. I have a meeting, but at 7 p.m. you can come to the to meet me. From there, we can go to the, not just for the sports shop. I need new shoes, so we'll go to the. Okay, خلينا نحل مع بعض. Mom, I have to play a match today. I need to go to clothes shop. Not now, Ahmed. I have a meeting, but at 7 p.m. you can come to the coffee shop to meet me. From there, we can go to the sports shop. Mom, not just for sports shop. I need new shoes, so we also will go to the shoe shop. Okay, now please check your answer by yourself. Put the mark that you deserve. Just the mark that you deserve. حط العلامة اللي انت بتستحقها فقط. The last slide here. عندنا واجب بسيط. افتح كتابك صفحة 4 إذا متوفر. إذا مش متوفر هاي الصورة أمامك. طبعا أنا وفرت لك الكتاب على كل صورة من الكتاب. صورة الكتاب متوفرة معك لأني صورت لك الصورة. And I hope that you will open your book page 4 and 5. افتح كتابك الورقة اللي معك اعتبرها الكتاب وافتح صفحة هي موجودة 4 و 5. Look carefully to the picture and try to use the phrases. في عندي في صفحة 4 مجموعة من العبارات غير المكتملة. تمام؟ Try to match every phrase with the appropriate phrases. كل فريز حاول توصله ببعضه بالآخر. To what? In order to what? In order to create or to write a brief paragraph about the picture. Write it down and show me it in the class. بدي أشوفها في الصف. And try to upload it using Google Classroom. حاول تحملها في المكان المناسب على جوجل كلاس روم. That's it. Thank you very much.